Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. Dilapidation reports and precondition surveys are used to document the condition of a building or asset before any construction actually starts on the project. Usually it's done to identify, for example, any anomalies or existing defects so that it's clear that these were pre-existing and not caused by the planned construction work that's about to start. So in this video, we're going to look at how we can capture an organized really high quality precondition surveys and dilapidation reports inside of Dashpivot. So we've got our dilapidation report template already set up inside of Dashpivot. No forms have been created yet, so the first step is to click this green button over here to click Add Report. When we click this, it opens up our dilapidation report form, and we can start to fill some of this out. Maybe we pop in the date. We're working in or observing zone 2. We can add a description of the area. We can select what key inspection items we're looking at. Maybe today we're looking at the nature strip, for example. We can draw a plan view and I guess sketch on here the areas that we are inspecting and draw on there any defects, circle any defects on here. We can add photos, and this is a big one for dilapidation reports. Using the Dashpivot app, if you're doing a walk and you spot some defects or you want to take some photos of the condition of an asset, you can click Add Photos. It will open up the camera. You can take the photo. You can add any descriptions. You can tag it. And then once you save that back into Dashpivot, it'll also have recorded the GPS location. So it'll tell you who took the photo, where it was taken, when it was taken, and any comments, descriptions, and tags. So that will all get captured in here inside of Dashpivot as well. This particular template has a crack mapping sketch. So if we wanted to sketch something on here, again, similarly to above, we can go ahead and do that. And then we've got a checkbox at the bottom and a signature. So once we've filled out this form and we're happy with it, we can click Save. And we'll end up with our form now sitting here inside of Dashpivot. And this is just one, I guess, dilapidation report which has been filled out. But over time, you may end up with several over a few days. And you might end up with something that looks a little bit more like this. And what's really handy about Dashpivot is that if we want to view these records in a register, we can do that by just clicking the register view over here. And so what it will do is it will convert our forms into rows where each of the columns in our register represents one of the fields that we had. So we had a field for the zone, we had a field for photos, we had a field for the description of the area, date of inspection, etc. And that's all displayed here in our register. What's really neat about this is that we can apply filters. So if we'd done a couple of different reports across multiple zones and we wanted to, for example, just look at the reports from zone 3, click zone 3, apply the filter, and then it's going to return only the dilapidation reports which have been associated or assigned to zone 3. We can do that with any category field that we have set up. So we've got that here for the key inspection items as well. So we could do that based on this. We could do it based on the date. There's lots of different options to choose from. And the other great thing about the register view, particularly for dilapidation reports, is that if we need to export this information, whether it's to a CSV file, if we want to have like a register in Excel of everything, or we want to have a PDF export that we can then hand to someone as a report, we can bulk select multiple forms at once. So we can select either individually or we can select all. And the exporting options appear at the top. So we can export it to CSV, we can download this whole register as a PDF, or we can download each individual form as a PDF as well. And we can also, in addition to that, on the topic of distributing the report later down the track after it's been completed, we can also just, from inside Dashpivot, if we open up one of these forms, we actually have a send as PDF option up the top here as well. So we can click on that, type in someone's email address and hit send, and they'll receive a PDF version of this form which has been filled out. So if you want to get started with a dilapidation report template inside of Dashpivot, Inside the template section, if you click on Add New Template and go to our free public template library and search for Dilapidation Report or Precondition Survey, it'll come up with the template which we've run through as an example today. So you can get started with that. And of course, with all the templates inside of Dashpivot, they're all customizable. So you can take out certain things, add different things, change some of those dropdowns and those category fields to suit the project that you're working on. And that's how you can really streamline and track a lot of your dilapidation reports inside of Dashpivot and your precondition surveys inside of Dashpivot. It really makes it easy to capture all of those records, organize all of those records, and then of course distribute those records or search for them later down the track when it's required. If you need a hand with anything, we do have a live chat on the website. So you can click this button here, open up the live chat, send through a message. But we also have a knowledge base built in here where we can search for different articles that we've got written. Most of the articles contain a video or two, so it makes it really easy to sort of get to understand how Dashpivot works and all the things that you can do in it. So I hope that this has really been useful, and as always, thanks for watching.